other words, they are drivers, and they are the handlers of the dog. So they will command the dog from their position to drive. So we expect the dog to stay still for the required length of time. They are timed with a stopwatch. They are then told you may release your dogs. So ladies, you may release your dogs. Thank you for demonstrating the staying position. No one of the exercises we have is all our distraction exercise. It is not along in a prime position, which could be either behind the carriage or alongside. You then have somebody walk down in the opposite direction of the dog, and the dog, now mentioned, must stay in this position. Now, you should only do that. We're not going to explain that today. We should bring it on the audience. One of the other exercises is to speak. Some of them are very nicely already starting to demonstrate that. But I'm going to ask them to go into an extended trot or a canter and to demonstrate the speed exercise. So I'm going to come down the middle, demonstrating speed, and you will see the pace of the dog has changed from a trot into a run. These dogs are quite big and are keeping up with anything. They are longer endurance, they have plenty of heart and lumbering room, as you can see with a nice big chest, so they will be strong for the miles that they can. They are capable of good bursts of speed, particularly when they're sitting on the valley across the world.
The way it can be is not on the bottom. It's always on the bottom.
Foundations are extremely versatile. A number of these girls here today have competed in the showroom for us. They've done agility. They've done obedience. They are a remarkably two-room energetic dog. Needs well planned, as you can see, can be trained to a very nice character. They are used in the United States for tracking, they are then used to the arm of the belt ability, used as a high-dog